Hi friends, welcome to the lesson 2 of batch scripting. Today we will learn about some basic but important command in batch scripting. So let's start off by opening the text editor. Here I am using Notepad++ and I will create a bat file here. We learned this in the previous session on how to create a bat executable file. I will share the link in the description for that. So the list of commands that we will use today are echo, pause, rem, cd and cls. So let's start with echo. Echo is a built-in command in bash and C shell that write its argument to the standard output. So what it mean? So let's see. Write echo and give the argument hello world. Save this and create a .bat file. Double click on the bat file to execute the script. When we double click on the file, interpreter reads the command inside the file and execute them one by one. Once all the commands are executed, the program gets terminated. Here we want to see what has been written back by the command in the script file. For that, we need to hold the output screen before the program gets terminated. In this case, we will use the command pause. Pause prompts the user and wait for a line of input to be entered. So it will hold the output screen for us. So see, it is asking for press any key to continue. If I press any key, the execution of the program gets terminated. So the pause keyword helps to hold the output window and will wait for a line of input to be executed. And if you see here, you can notice that echoing has been by default enabled. So we need to disable this. To disable batch while echoing, we have to use the statement @ echo of at the very beginning of the file. So this echo of turn off the echoing feature and @ at the beginning of the command prevent the echo command itself from being echoed. So if I save this and run the bat file again, it will only show me the output that we are printing here from the echo command. So the next keyword that we will use is rem. The rem batch command is used for remark in the batch file, preventing the content of remark from being executed. So whatever I will write inside this will not get executed. So let's see. Here you can see only hello world is getting printed. And I have written == sign inside the rem, but it's not getting printed. Suppose I don't want this hello world to be printed too. So just put rem in the beginning, save the file and execute. You can see only the pause command is there. That's holding the screen for us. So that's the rem command for you, remark command, preventing the content of remark from being executed. So the next command that comes is cd. CD batch command help in making changes to a different directory or display the current directory. CD without any parameter is used to display the current directory. So let's see. Double click, you can see my current directory. If you want to change the directory, you just need to write CD and the path. So I want to change to this directory. So let's take the path. Come here, give path, save it. Execute the file. Here nothing gets printed because you have only changed the path, but you are not displaying that. So to display the path, you need to use cd without any parameters. So now if I double click on the file, you can see the change directory. It says batch script. And the last command, that's the clear screen command, cls. What it will do, it will clear the prompt screen for us. So write cls, save this, double click on the file, everything will be clear. Only press any key to continue is there. That's the pause key that's holding the screen for us. So that was all for this video. In the next video, we will learn about the advanced batch commands. Thanks for watching this video. We'll see you guys in the next session. Thank you.